over. Yes.
Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for joining me on another glorious day in Ayrshire, Scotland. Now today I've got myself and James with me. Andy might join us later on. I'm not really too sure what he's up to today, but he said they might try and head down for a few hours. We're on the same permission, we're on the old church fields, but we've moved fields. Now we are further down the property. Now I believe that there's a scheduled monument about half a mile that direction, so we're steering well clear of that. Don't want any sort of bother, it's not worth the hassle. So if you're new to the channel, I like to keep things nice and honest, no planted digs, so expect to see a lot of junk being dug. But in amongst it all, there's a few nice finds as well, so so stay tuned, let's see how we got on, and we'll see you on the first hole. Alright, this is the first one we're going to have a look at. It's a 55. We've not long started, I've literally just... switched the machine on. I've not got the speaker on just now, because we're basically right next to the house, and it's pretty early. Yeah, we're out. We're over here somewhere. Get the pinpoint it. I think it's going to be a bit of junk. What have we got? Yeah, just a bit of copper or a bit of brass. Oh, dropped it. So here we go. First hard to get today, just a bit of junk. Top. Never did a live dig as usual, and I think it's another bit of silver. I'm pretty confident. I've given James a little shout, so we'll see what he thinks and we'll come straight back. You're not okay. And tell me what's wrong and why you never said you felt that way. Guess you're trying to stay strong and fake a smile until I look away. But I've known you too long, it hurts to watch your blue eyes fade to grey as you fade away. Okay, so I'm going to take a look at this one. It's not a great signal. Close to surface again, it's a 60. Yeah, it's a bit broken, so it's probably a bit of junk. In fact, it's definitely a bit of junk. Right under there. I don't think it's too deep. Let's just take a little bit of the top off it. Nope. Yeah, let's get the pinpointer. Where are we? I can't believe that silver coin. That's crazy. Yeah, what is happening here? Oh, we're over here somewhere. Is that it? What is that? Oh, just a bit of lead. Yep, a bit of lead. Anyway, on we go. Okay, so another 61. This one sounds a bit better though. We are out. Doesn't sound as good now. We're in here somewhere. What's this here? I think it might be a button or... Yeah, it's some sort of... I think it's some sort of button that's been squashed. Probably military. Pretty small. You can see that's the back. and then the front has been sort of caved in, so it's a little two-piece button. As I say, it's probably military. Yeah, not a bad little find, happy with that. A little sunbather right on the surface. A little watchfinder. Yeah, I love finding these little guys. Excellent. This is turning out to be a very, very good field. Right, so this is a great sounding target. It's a steady 84. There's a little crackle right at the end of it. But so I'm going to say this is a coin. It sounds a bit worse now that I've maybe moved it, mind. Needs to get some more silver. We are out. So, let's get the pin. What did we say it was? It sounds a bit junky as well. Might just be a bit of aluminium. No, there we go. A coin. Looks like a big penny. You can see that there. Excellent. It's very smooth. Probably Victoria. Don't want to rub it. It's a bit crusty. So it's, you can see just round the rim there, and it says one, and it'll say penny on that side. So that'll be Britannia on that one. Who have we got? I think it might be... No, I don't know. I'm not sure. Now I'll let it dry off and I'll give it a little clean and we'll come straight back. Oh, there we go. Victoria, one penny. Now I think it's either 1867 or 1857. Although it could now be 1887. As I say, I'm blind. Me and ask James and he says, "Oh, I'm blind without my glasses as well." So it's the blind leading the blind, as they say. Two coins in 20 minutes, absolutely fantastic. Right, so this is the next one we're going to have a look at. I've just let James have a listen to it, and as you can hear, it is a cracking signal. 94. All the way around. To me, and I broke my machine, and I broke the mount on my DS2. It was always going to happen, wasn't it? Right, so let's pinpoint it. It's right under there. Come on, let it be something good. Where are we? We're out. We are out, and whatever it is big. Sounds quite big. Don't think it's a coin. Nah. It's a big bit of junk. I can see writing on it. Oh god. Right, on we go. So we're very close to an airport, and we've got some pilot training happening today. So expect to hear a lot of background noise. I believe it's Ryanair. You can see this one coming in. Yeah, and I'll get a little video of it coming in, because it's basically going to be right over the top of our heads. Very low. And get into land. So that will do that. Everybody's seen an aeroplane before, haven't they? This is the first decent signal I've had in absolutely ages. It's just been junk after junk after junk. After such a promising start. So this one's a 66 all the way around. Nice and steady, nice and crisp. There's been a lot of lead. A lot of little scraps of lead. So We're in here somewhere, I think. Not in there. Still in here? Yeah, we're in here somewhere. Okay, might have dropped it. I think that might be it. It is more junk. It's not lead. Don't know what it is. It's junk anyway. Any ideas what this could be? Just lying on the surface. Getting a bit of light. It looks like the eye of a sewing needle. Is that a rain guide? What could that be? I don't see anything on it. Pass. Don't know. If anybody has any ideas, let me know. I've had to take the remote off. The little bit that was broken has now come away completely. So it's going to be... I've got the remote in my pocket. I've got this one here. It's a 76-77. Well, when I checked it on my phone, so... I'll come back if it's anything decent. Here we go, first button of the day. Still got the loop on the back as well. I don't see any writing on it. There's no design on it. And I'm pretty unsure about the age. Doesn't look too old, to be honest. That's it. So that's the first button we've had today. Yeah, we keep going on. Okay, so this is a pretty good sounding one. And a little bit of a buzz at the end there, but we'll check it out anyway. We're out. Let's see what we have. Come on. Oh, is that a coin? Is that a coin? Oh. I think this might be a penny. Is that a modern penny? It looks like it. Yeah, I'm going to say that's a one pence piece. Actually can't see anything. Let me wipe it and give it a little dry off, and we'll see what it is. Yep, it's a one pence. It sounded really good. The back is pretty toasted. I can't get any detail, but I can see Queen Elizabeth II on the front there. So, yep, 3 coins for today so far. Yep. Check this one out. I think it's a big button. Oh, yeah. Is that a dandy button? It's pretty big. Tom back, I think. Yep. That's pretty cool. A nice big button. That's 2 for today. Yeah, I don't like not having the remote. Let's say I use the remote. I listen to the tones, but I just like to check the numbers. And occasionally change a couple of the sentences I'm going, but it's a bit of a pain. Poor design, it's really weak. So XP need to sort that out. I know you can get sort of 3D aftermarket ones. I've actually got a couple in the house, but I've never thought that I would need them, and lo and behold, I didn't bring anything with me. So yeah, remote's in the pocket, so need to sort that when I get up the road. It's a bit of a shame. So contact Regton and get one of these priced up. But I know that they're just going to be as poorly made as this one, unfortunately. Yep, come on XP, get your finger out, get it sorted. Okay, another decent sounding signal. Solid 88. So that's kind of coin territory, but it could also be aluminium can. So I'm going to say it's round about there. It'd be nice if it was another coin, particularly silver, but it's not sounding so good now. We're out. Right, so I'm kind of getting used to the remote being in my pocket. It's kind of weird. You don't rely on the remote, so your ears are tuning in better. It's quite strange, actually. I still think I would prefer to have the remote on the mount kind of thing. But yeah, there we go. Big bit of crap. Don't know if there's some sort of latch, possibly. Yeah, it's a good sounding signal. I think it's a big lump of brass. Anyway, on we go. So I've got myself another little button, and it's quite a cool little one. It's really small, kind of cufflink. You still see the loop in the back, but there's a little design on the front. Some sort. I don't know if that's coming out really that well on there, but yeah, it's interesting. Don't know whether that'll be military again, or it's a sort of, there's a sort of flower design on it, possibly. Don't know. I'll be able to clean that up a bit better. That looks quite old, actually. Yeah, that's nice. Pleased with that. And that's three buttons for today. Alright, so we had that little button just about 15 foot up that way. And this is a great sounding signal. Let's check the numbers, actually. I think I'll dig out the remote. It's a bit of a pain, but 87. Maybe a bit big. It's overloading the horseshoe, I suppose. Still in there. Is that it there? Is that what I can see? What have we got down here? I can see something round. I don't know whether you can see that. Something there. Maybe a bit dark. Let's just check. It is a coin. Thank the Lord. There's a big helicopter going by. Let me just show you the big helicopter. A big military type thing. See that there? British, foreign, you get a lot of other countries coming in here. Cool, anyway, back to the coin. Let me just stick you back in the harness. Okay, what we got? What do we have? I'll zoom you back out, actually, because you're a bit close. That's better. Let's try and move that. It's definitely a coin. It's a funny shape. You know, it's pretty old. It looks like it could be George III. I'm not getting much off at all. It's pretty battered. I'm trying to get a bit of a... Yeah, I don't know. I'm going to take a stab in the dark. George III. Yeah, I don't see anything off that. It's had a hard life, this coin, anyway. But it's missing off it. I'd say it's... Well, I don't know. It might not be thick enough for George III, but... Could be a Victoria. Could just be a really poor Victoria. Yeah, it could be. Is that coming out on there? Anyway, it's a coin. Coin number 4. Fantastic. On we go to the next. We've got another one here, and I think I don't even need to do anything more than pointing in the right direction, which is right there, poking out the surface. I'm going to say it's another coin. It is. 5 coins for today. So there's Britannia on the back. Quite a nice bit of detail. Britannia on the back. Who have we got in the front? It is Edward. Edward. So that'll be 1901 to 1910. James got a nice Edward earlier on, it's a lovely coin. A lovely bust on it. I'll try and get a picture of it and let you see it compared to that. So that's what, 5 today? 5 coins for today, fantastic. I wouldn't mind them all like that, just poking out the surface. Yeah, excellent. On to the next. There we go, that's James's coin there. And you can see it's an absolute beauty. It's Tanya on the back. Did you get a date off that, James?
No.
Nah, no yet. Can't see anything there. Can't see anything. It's not coming out. They're very nice though. Lovely. Anyway, on we go. Well, that's us for another day. I'm going to wrap it up there. Andy and James are still out there somewhere, but I'm almost at the end. Yeah, a bit of a strange day. Started off really well. Got that little Victoria Silver, and then I didn't have anything for ages. And then I got another four coins. So it's not too bad. Really disappointed that I broke the mount for the control box for the machine, so I'll need to try and sort out that. But surprisingly, I quite enjoyed not having it there. It was just almost like another distraction that was taken away. So I don't know whether you prefer seeing the control box and hearing it. If you don't mind not hearing it, then I might just continue to have it in my pocket and just dig by tone, because it was quite enjoyable actually. So if you've enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. Again, check out Regton as well, use the code TAD10, that'll get you 10% off most items, not everything. And if you want to help support the channel, you can buy me a coffee, the link is in the description. A couple of quid goes a long way. Everything gets put into a little savings account, and it helps buy new equipment for the channel. So if you're feeling a little flush this month, head over to there and donate a little to the channel, and I'll give you a little shout out as well. So so we'll head off just now, another big plane there, and we'll see you next time. Thank you very much for watching, and take care.